I'm looking through a pinhole at that car out there, and Leonardo's thought was, you draw on glass, and by drawing on the glass, you can get the shapes right.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you can see that, but if you get down low, you can see the line I'm making up against the sky. If this was a room I was trying to draw, I would end up with all the lines in the right perspective.
Right.
And Leonardo, genius that he was, he realized that this was what he called a visual pyramid. If this is the top of the pyramid, you can imagine a pyramid going out from your painting.
Going deep.
Yeah. And your painting, he thought, if it was to look accurate, should be like looking through a pane of glass.
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of a new idea. So this is one way that they traced. Now, mm-hmm. obviously, when I'm doing this, but even though I'm not an artist, I'm getting the shapes right.
Absolutely. We know it's a Mini Cooper.
Right. That looks like a Mini Cooper. So, being artistic, you could probably make a stab at drawing me.
I could give it a whack. But I find this thing gets in the way. I can do it
okay.
easier,
all right.
like so.
Okay, if that works.
Yeah.
But moving your head obviously shifts things around. I'll try not to move my head. And obviously, people can do this without the grid. You probably could, I probably couldn't.
Yeah, I'm going faster than I normally would, but again, my head moving around is making things a little weird too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, but that's generally the idea.
Yep. So that way, you could, get the shapes right, get the proportion right, and that, solves one of their perspective problems. If they were looking out at the a plaza with a lot of buildings, all they would have to do is, figure out where the line of the building intersected these squares. The angles all come out right.
Actually, an amusing story in the middle of all this is that when I was an art teacher at Rhode Island School of Design, one of the assignments I gave my drawing class was to deal with the vanishing point. And that was a drawing assignment over the weekend, however you interpret it. And I'll never forget, one of the drawings was a gentleman named Bill Burke, who went on to become a pretty good photographer, who came in, and basically it was a drawing of himself walking into his apartment and finding his girlfriend in bed with another gentleman. And he said, and that was my vanishing point. and he got an A on the test. It was great.
What jumped out at me looking at the Vermeers was not the accuracy of the shapes of things, but the accuracy of the value of things.
Interesting. Okay,
so the value is another word for brightness. Mm-hmm. Photographers call it value, artists call it value. I'm a video guy, we call it brightness or gray level. And it's extremely accurate in the Vermeers, almost inhumanly accurate. So, on these walls, there's this very realistic shading
mm-hmm.
that you don't find in too many other artists. Vermeer nailed it. These shadows here, like underneath this rod, are exactly the type of shadow that would be cast if there were two large open windows right here.
Okay.
And you can see the double shadow a bit here.
Right.
That's extremely accurate. Chapters have been written about Vermeer's walls. They called him the painter of light and the light-filled rooms of Vermeer. Well, obviously, you can't paint with light, you paint with paint. But somehow, he was able to nail those values.